In this video, we'll try to understand the concept of block break. So here we'll consider the single block break. The arrangement for which is shown in the given particular figure. So as you can see over here, we are having the single block break, and the various terms which are involved in this are also shown over here. So this is the rotating drum which we want to stop by applying the breaking force F. So this is the brake drum, this is the breaking force which is applied on this particular level. And this is the block or shoe which is pressed against this particular drum so that the rotating drum will be stopped. This is the tangential force which is acting on this lever or acting on this block. X is the distance. Then L is the distance of this particular applied force from the fulcrum O. Now the various force components, they are also shown over here. So this is the force which is acting in the downward direction, which is the force applied by a person so that he can press this block or shoe against this rotating drum. The normal reaction will be applied by this drum on this block, and that is acting in the upward direction because the block or the shoe is pressed in the downward direction. Now the tangential force or breaking force is FB, and this particular FB component which we have shown is on the block and not on the drum. On the drum, it will be acting in the opposite direction. So on this particular drum, this tangential component will act exactly in the opposite direction. So this, you can say that we can draw this component over here. So this is the component of the force which is acting on the rotating drum, that is FB, and multiplied by this radius of the drum will produce the clockwise torque which will oppose this rotational motion which is already there in the anti-clockwise direction. But the equal component will be equal and opposite component will act on the lever. And for the analysis purpose, as we are going to consider the free body diagram of the lever, this component of FB is shown in the opposite direction, which is acting on the lever and not on the drum. The line of action of this FB is passing through this fulcrum O, as shown over here. The distance of this normal reaction Rn, normal is nothing but what it is, perpendicular, which is drawn at the point of contact of this shoe and the drum over here. So the distance X is nothing but the distance of the normal reaction from the fulcrum O, and L is the distance between the fulcrum O and the point of application of force F. So we have removed that drum over here, and only we have shown the block or the shoe. Now we'll take the moments about this point O, considering that the clockwise moments, they are considered as positive, whereas anti-clockwise moments, they are considered as negative. So we'll start with this Rn. So this Rn will produce anti-clockwise moment about point O. And as we have considered, the anti-clockwise moments, they are negative. So force is Rn and the perpendicular distance is X. So this Rn into X is the anti-clockwise or negative moment over here. The point of application of this FB, it is already passing through this O. So it will not have any moment about this because perpendicular distance is zero. So this line of action is passing through this O, and there is no perpendicular distance between FB and O. So it is FB into zero. Then this force F, it will produce the clockwise moment about O, and the force is F and the perpendicular distance from F up to this point O is nothing but what? It is L. So this F into L will be the clockwise moment. So transfer this negative term on this side. So we'll get the value of normal reaction. So it is will be FL divided by X. Now we know that FP is breaking force or tangential force, and that is nothing but in mechanics we have seen that it is mu into normal reaction, so that is mu into Rn, and torque is nothing but breaking force into radius, so it will be breaking force into R, where R is the drum radius. Now substitute the value of FP. FP is nothing but what? It is mu into Rn. Now substitute the value of Rn, which we have obtained by taking the moments about fulcrum. So it is FL upon X and multiplied by R. So this will be the value of breaking torque in Newton meter. Now let us see another case in which we are having the line of action of this tangential breaking force, which is passing through a distance of A below the fulcrum. So the fulcrum is O, and breaking force is acting at a distance of A below this particular O. Now in this particular case, again, if we take the moments about point O, then start with this Rn. This Rn will produce, so you can see this Rn will produce again anti-clockwise moments because of this Rn, and this Rn multiplied by the perpendicular distance is X. And as it is producing anti-clockwise moment, it is Rn into X, and it is negative. Then this breaking force, it will produce the clockwise moment about this O. So FB and perpendicular distance is A, so it is clockwise moment, so it is FB into A. Similarly, this F, it will also produce a clockwise moment about this point, fulcrum point O. And perpendicular distance is nothing but what? It is L. So F into L will be the clockwise moment which is produced because of this applied force F, which will press this block against this rotating drum, which is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction. Now transfer this negative term Rn into X on the other side, so it will become positive. And again transfer this FP into A term, so this is positive, it will come on the other side and will become negative. But we know that breaking force is nothing but mu into Rn. So we can take this Rn term common from both these terms. So it is Rn into bracket X minus mu A. Or we can say that normal reaction can be written as FL divided by this X minus mu A. Now, again, we know that the breaking force is mu into R. Breaking torque is breaking force into radius, that is R. And again substitute the value of FB, that is mu into Rn, but the value of Rn we have already obtained by taking the moment about the fulcrum O. So this is the value of Rn which we can substitute over here. So it is mu into FL divided by X minus mu into R. Now the most important part is just cross multiply by this X minus mu A to this breaking torque, which is on the other side. So this TB into X minus mu A is equal to mu into F into L into R, where this mu is nothing but coefficient of friction. So this concept we have already studied in our applied mechanics. Now we want to find out the value of this force, breaking force, or the force which is applied by the person at the end of the lever. So it is the external force, not the breaking force. So it is mu L into R, this term we have taken on this side. So it will be TB into X minus mu A divided by mu L R. Now if you substitute X is equal to mu A, or rather if we are having the value of X such that it matches with the value of mu A, then X minus mu A, that term will be zero because X is equal to mu A. So it is mu A minus mu A, then the force that is applied by a person at the end of the lever will be zero. In other words, when this condition is satisfied, then such a break is known as the self-locking break. Now, the moment of force FB, tangential force FB, in the earlier side, we have seen that this FB, the moment that is created by this breaking force, tangential breaking force FB, is in the same direction as that of the applied force F. So it helps in applying the brake. Then such a brake is known as the self-energized brake. So let us go back to understand this concept to the earlier side. So you can see over here, the breaking force, this FB is producing the clockwise moment, and this F is also producing the clockwise moment about point O. So we can say that this tangential breaking force is helping this force F to apply the brake on this rotating drum. And therefore, when such condition is satisfied, then it is known as the self-energizing brake. Now, let us see the another condition, that is the case 3, when we are having the line of action of the tangential braking force, which passes through a distance A above the fulcrum. So, fulcrum is located over here, that is O, and the distance of this particular fulcrum is A above the, or the braking force is A above this particular fulcrum. So this FB is acting at a distance of A above this fulcrum. Now here also we can take the moments about point A, point O, and the conventions are clockwise positive and anti-clockwise negative. So again, start with this Rn. Again, it will produce the anti-clockwise moment about the fulcrum O. So it is negative. Then this braking force, it is also producing the anti-clockwise moment about O. So here also it is negative, but this F, which is acting in the downward direction, will produce a clockwise moment about this point O. So, and the perpendicular distance is this F multiplied by this L. So F into L is the perpendicular distance. Now transfer this negative Rn X term, correct, on the other side it will become positive, and again transfer this negative FB into A term also on this side, it will become positive. Now substitute the value of FB, that is nothing but mu into Rn, and take again Rn common, so it is X plus mu A. Or we can say that normal reaction Rn will be equal to FL divided by X plus mu A. Again, applying the same concept as we have seen earlier. So the braking force is mu into Rn, braking torque is braking force into R. And then substitute the value of braking force, that is nothing but mu into Rn, and substitute the value of Rn, that is nothing but this particular value, FL upon X plus mu A in place of this Rn. And we will obtain the braking torque required for the application of the brake. So in this way, we can apply the concept of our mechanics to this analysis of single block brake. Thank you very much for watching.